And the learned men, they say that this is a tawbah, meaning repentance, a warning. Therefore, there is no greeting. For example, if you are walking on the street and someone snatches your bag and you run away and you catch him and you will directly take him, you will not say assalamu alaikum, kaifa halak, how are you, give me the bag. You will not say anything. You will directly come into the subject and say, hey, give me the bag, otherwise I'll break your arm. You will directly give the subject. That is what Allah says. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the initial ayat of Surah Tawbah, He is giving the warning to the mushrik of Makkah. Put things right in 3 months, otherwise war from Allah and His Rasul. And they unilaterally break the treaty. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَبَشِّرِ الَّذِينَ عَذَابٌ عَلِيمٌ. Give glad tidings to the mushriks for the grievous penalty and the punishment. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He comes to ayah number 24 of Surah Tawbah, He is addressing us, the Muslims. We are now at the firing line. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not talking about the Nasara. He's not talking about the Yahudi or the Mushrik or the Kafir. He is talking about us. You Muslims, قل, say to them, إِن كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ, whether it be your parents, وَأَبْنَاؤُكُمْ, or whether it be your children, وَإِخْوَانُكُمْ, or your siblings, your brothers and sisters, وَأَزْوَاجُكُمْ, or your wives or husbands, وَأَشِيرَتُكُمْ, and the relatives or the friends. Allah calls these 5 relations. You can't think of any other one. 5 relations. Your parents, your children, your wives or husbands, your brothers and sisters, your relatives and friends. 5 relations. Allah goes further. وَأَمْوَالُ نِخْتَرَفْتُمُوهَا, and the wealth that you have amassed so far, the wealth that you have gathered so far. وَأَمْوَالُ نِخْتَرَفْتُمُوهَا وَتِجَارَةٌ تَخْشَوْنَ كَسَادَهَا, and the businesses and the jobs in which you fear a loss, saying that I don't have time, I'm so busy in my jobs. Allah says, is that your consideration? وَتِجَارَةٌ تَخْشَوْنَ كَسَادَهَا وَمَسَاكِينُ تَرَدَوْنَهَا, and the dwellings, the big houses, the villas that in which you love to live. If these 5 relations and these 3 things, أحب إليكم من الله, if these 8 things are dearer to you, are more considerable to you, more than Allah, ورسوله, His Rasul, وجهاد في سبيله, and striving in His cause, فتربصوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you wait, فتربصوا, حتى يأتي الله بأمره, until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings about His decision upon you. وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِقِينَ, and Allah will never guide the rebellious people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not guide the perverted transgressors. You see, in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calls parents, children, wives and husbands, sisters, brothers, every relation. And we are working for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given these blessings. Our parents are the blessings for us. But we are so busy in our own parents that we forget the message of Islam. We are busy in our own sisters and brothers that we forget the message of Islam. We are busy so much in bringing up our own children who are the blessings from Allah. And we are forgetting the message. My dear brothers and sisters, I urge you, please not wait. Allah says, فَتَرَبَّصُوا, you wait. That does not mean wait. For example, if you hit a boy of 10 or 12 in this area, Dera, Dubai, if you hit a boy and he says, uncle, you wait. You wait and I'll get my brother and I'll see you. And his brother is considered to be a biggest bully. He's a hooligan in Dera. Are you going to wait for him? Are you going to wait for him? No. If he says wait, that does not mean wait. When he says wait, that does not mean wait. That alarm, look out. It's a warning. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the same tone, He's saying, فَتَرَبَّصُوا, you wait. And we are waiting. Wallah, we are waiting. 800 years we spent in Spain, the Muslims, they ruled, dominion, authority, power, everything in the hands of Spain, the Muslims. But we didn't do the job. We did not do the job. They might be good Muslims, praying 5 times a day, doing all tasbih, going to Hajj, the pilgrimage. They might be fasting. They might give sadaqah, zakat, everything good in that. But they did not do the message. And after 800 years, can you imagine? 800 years, there was not a single Muslim who could give Aran after they were conquered. after they were conquered by other people, there was not a single Muslim who could give adhan. What a pathetic situation that was. 800 years, we did not do the job. They waited and they destroyed. That is how Allah does. About 1,000 years in India, we had rule, dominion, authority, power, everything. But we did not do the job. All that we could see is the big tombs and tombs, Taj Mahal, these things we could see. But they did not do the job. They might be good Muslims at their own site, but they did not convey the message. And they were replaced. That is how Allah works. He activates another people and they will be replaced. They will be replaced. Allah says in Surah Muhammad, Surah number 47, Ayat number 38, وَإِن تَتَوَلَّوْا يَسْتَبْدِلْ قَوْمًا غَيْرَكُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَكُونُ أَمْثَالَكُمْ. If you people, if you Muslims, if you turn back from your duty, from your job, you will be replaced by the people who will never be like you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He chooses the people who are most despicable in your sight. Meaning whom you will look down upon. He will do the job. This black man, he will do the job. Filipino, he will do the job. Will he understand about Islam? That is what the thinking of the Arabs initially. Who will understand us? Those people, that is what the thinking of the Spanish people. We are going to deliver the message to the Arabs, those barbaric people. What will they will understand about Islam? They will not understand about Islam. The Arabs, the pagans, they were the people who used to marry their own stepmother. They were the people, those barbaric people, who used to burn and bury their butter alive. The Arabs in Yawm al-Jahiliya, meaning in the days of ignorance before Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they used to bury their daughters alive. Those people, will they understand about Islam? Allah chose us, our Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the land of Arabia, and he became the best person on the face of the earth and conveyed the message. He brought the glad tidings, the good news of Jannah, and he warns people about Jahannam. Be prepared. Do it or you will be replaced. And wallah, it's a high time that you have to account for yourselves. Alhamdulillah, you all came here. That itself is the evidence that you have the concern, the burning in your belly to propagate Islam. You have the concern towards Islam that you can do that job. And we have to do this job. This is our own response. There is no Nabi after Muhammad. Our Muhammad says, La Nabi Abad. There is no Nabi after me. So the message is on the shoulders of the Muslims. Account for yourselves. How many years have you been in this UAE, in Dubai? And how many people have you conveyed the message of Islam? You might be working with them for 10 hours, 12 hours, 13 hours, might be 18 hours. Some people work here. I have seen. They work. But account for yourself. Ask yourself. You are the best judge of your own self. Ask ourselves that, have I delivered the message of Islam to all of them? Otherwise Allah says, فَتَرَبَّصُوا, you wait and we will be destroyed. We or our children will be destroyed. We should not wait, my dear brothers and sisters. With these words, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Tawbah, Surah number 9, Ayat number 33, هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق. It is he who has sent his apostle, his Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with the guidance and the religion of truth. ليظهره على الدين كله. To proclaim, to prevail it over all the other religions. ولو كره المشركون. Even though the mushriks, the kafirs may dislike it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's promise is truth. وعد الله حقه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when says that he will proclaim, supersede all the other ways of life about Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will proclaim the message of Islam with us or without us. Now it is our privilege, our duty, how good we can contribute to this noble deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and became of those category, of those kind whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about in Surah Ali Imran, Surah number 3, Ayat number 104, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that, let there arise out of you a group of people who invite all that is good and forbid all that is bad. And those people are the real successful people in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.